If you don't have alerts on your stream, you're missing out on the opportunity to be able to get more followers, more subscribers, and more donation. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and set up your alerts inside of OBS Studio. And make sure you stick around to the end where I'm going to show you how to go ahead and set donations so you can start earning some money on your stream. Let's go ahead and dive in. So the very first thing you want to do is you want to make sure you have your OBS Studio open. Then once you have that open, you're going to want to go to the link in the description of this video for streamelements.com. This is going to be the tool we're going to utilize to be able to set up our alerts. So once you're here, you're going to come to log in. It's going to prompt you to get connected with your streaming platform. I'm going to use Twitch for this example. And then it's going to ask you to go ahead and authorize Twitch to gain access to Stream Elements, and then you'll be brought to this dashboard here. On the left-hand side, you're going to select Streaming Tools. You're going to come to Overlays. And we're going to go ahead and name a new overlay. For the overlay resolution, we're going to leave it at 1080p. You're going to hit Start. And now what we're going to do is we're going to come to this plus icon, and we're going to select Alerts, and we're going to select Alert Box. Now you're going to see here all the alerts that we have available to be able to customize: follow alert, subscriber alert, tip, cheer, host, and raid. Now out of the gate, Stream Elements does give you some standard alerts that you can go ahead and utilize. So if you press the little gear icon, you're going to be able to edit all the assets of the follower alert. So if we come here to where it says emulate, this is how you test the alert. You come to follow alert, and you're going to see here, this is going to be the animation, the alert that appears. If you like the standard ones that comes from Stream Elements, you can go ahead and use those, pretty much hit save, and then you're able to go ahead and follow along after this. I like to use more custom alerts. So what I like to do is I like to come to streamdesigns.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video where they have tons of animated alerts that you can go ahead and choose from and different overlays. So once you go ahead and have your alert, what you're gonna wanna do is on Stream Elements, you're gonna come to where it says change video. Once you hit change video, you're gonna click upload, and then you're gonna go ahead and select the files. Now, if you went ahead and got this from Stream Designs, you're going to come, and it's initially going to come in a zip file just like this. You'll simply have to unzip it first. So if you don't know how to unzip a file, just simply go to Google and search how to do that. And then you'll get a folder just like this that's going to say alerts. And then here you're going to see new follower, new host, new donation, new bits, new subscriber. So I'm going to go ahead and say new follower. Now, I'm only going to show you guys how to set up two alerts in this video, simply because once you know how to do it one time, you can do it for all the others. So here it is right here. I'm going to hit submit. And now we can go ahead and test this and say follow event. And you're going to see here now that the animation for the alert has happened, but our text is not aligned. So to be able to adjust this, and these settings that I'm about to show you now are going to be different based on the alerts that you get. If you got your alerts from Stream Designs, then these settings that I'm going to give you are going to work just fine. So the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to come here on the left-hand side, and you're going to go ahead and select the layout. Then from there, what I like to do is I like to change this text from now from the name is not following. I like to put just followed. Okay. And then what you want to do is you want to go ahead and scroll down here to where it says text settings. And then we'll go ahead and enable custom font. And I like to use impact as it's going to look bold. So we'll come here and test this again. You'll see here that now it's there. And what we want to do is we want to come to advanced to be able to get this text to show up in this box. So if you're using, again, Stream Designs alerts, you're going to go ahead and put in the top, you're going to put negative 200. And then on the left, you're going to put 15. And then what I like to do is I like to go ahead and change the color of the name to match the alerts that I went ahead and got. So for this one, we use kind of like a yellow. So I'm going to leave that there. And now when I hit emulate and I do follow event, you're going to see here that the name now appears inside of the box. So now that we have that there, what I want you to do is to come back here. And I want to show you another alert because this is also going to be super important. So the subscriber alert, when you hit the little gear icon, you're going to be able to change this exactly as you would. But you're going to see here that the bottom, that it's going to go ahead and give you variation settings. So this is super important, right? Because when you do subscribers, maybe you want resubscribe, subscriber gift, and community gifts, and you want different alerts to be able to pop up. Either way, even if you want the same subscriber alert to change, you've got to come to gear, and then you'll be able to change all the different animations. How many months do you want? What's the sound? What's the image? And things of that sort. So that's how you're going to go ahead and make variations for the different kind of subscriber events. Now I want to show you how you can go ahead and add sound to these animations. Now, again, out of the gate, you're going to get one sound in Stream Elements. So again, if we hit here and we hit the follow event, and you're going to get one individual sound. Now, I like to go again and use custom sounds. Now, I personally utilize Epidemic Sounds. And again, I'll put a link in the description for Epidemic Sounds where you're able to get royalty-free music. And once you get logged in, you get a 30-day free trial to be able to utilize this. And then you come here to where it says sound effects, and you're going to see all the different options of sound effects that you have here available. So I'm going to go ahead and come down to the section that says games. And I'm going to go ahead and look through this music. I'm just going to go ahead and use the first one for this example. So once you found your sound effect, you come to the right, you select download format, you do MP3, and you simply go ahead and select download. Once you have that downloaded, you want to come back here into Stream Elements, and here where it says clear sound, you can clear it and then upload a sound. And now you can go ahead and select files. You can go to the download where you found that sound at, open it and add it here. And now you want to select submit. And now you're able to adjust the volume of that sound. So if I come and emulate this follower alert, now I'm gonna have the sound that I went ahead and set up for that animation. So what you want to do is you wanna go ahead and go one by one and set up all your alerts utilizing the steps that I just went ahead and showed you. Now let's go ahead and get this inside of OBS Studio so that way when somebody does go ahead and follow, subscribe, or donate, it pops up on screen. So to be able to do that, we wanna go ahead and hit save. We wanna go ahead and name this alerts. You're gonna hit save here. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna come up top to this little paperclip icon and click copy over overlay URL. Then we wanna come back here to OBS Studio, and you want to go ahead and place the alerts on every single scene that you're gonna go ahead and utilize. So if I want it on my countdown scene, I'm gonna press this plus icon. I'm gonna go ahead and use the browser. I'm gonna go ahead and name this alerts, and then I'm gonna say okay. And now what I want to do is I want to go ahead and paste in that URL that we just went ahead and copied from Stream Elements. The width, I'm going to do 1920 by 1080. And then we want to go ahead and select OK. Now you're going to see here that our alert is going to be placed on this element. Now it's very important that if you want your alerts to show, make sure that the alert is at the top of everything inside of your sources. And then under gameplay, we can come and press the plus icon again, and then we're able to go ahead and do browser source. And now you don't need to add it again. Click add existing, select alerts, and you want to do this for every single scene. Now let's go ahead and test this out to make sure everything is working. So to be able to test this, we come back to Stream Elements, we come to emulate. What I recommend is that you test every single one, but we go ahead and follow event, and I want you to click it a few times so it can pop up on OBS Studio for us, and you'll see here that now it's shown up. So what I want you to do is hold the option or the alt key, and I want you to just resize this so you can have more flexibility to be able to go ahead and move this around without having to go to Stream Elements. So now I can place this exactly where I want it to be, and then I can do check it out, same thing here inside of the gameplay scene. I can go ahead and move it as well and place it exactly where I want it to be. So now you can see here that we have our alerts, and the package that I'm utilizing that you're seeing here for the countdown timer and the alert is called the Lux package from Stream Designs. Now, what I want you to do is now that you have these alerts in place, you can go ahead and start to get more followers, more subscribers, and more donations, but you have to know how to set up donations so that it comes up on screen. So to be able to go ahead and set up donations, that way you can receive money and then it also appears on your stream when somebody donates, go ahead and click this video right here where I walk you step by step on setting up donations for your Twitch stream. I'll see you guys in the next video.